Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let me show you how to use the image stabilization feature in iMovie. It was really only a few years ago that something like video image stabilization was only a feature you'd get in expensive software or maybe not at all. But now it's pretty easy to do and you could just do it with iMovie that comes with your Mac. So I'm using the latest version of iMovie here, 10.1.3. It's been around for a while though. I'm going to take this video and drag it into my project here. So it's just I started a new project. I had this media in it already. And you could see here in the preview on the right that I was holding my iPhone pretty steadily when I took this. But it wasn't on a tripod or anything, so you can see some shake. Look at the corners of the video and you could really see up here how much shake there is. It doesn't look too bad, but I want to get it perfect. I want it to get it look like I took this with a tripod. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the video down here and I have the controls here at the top. I'm going to select the stabilization function there and then I'm going to turn it on. And what it's going to do if it's the first time you've ever used it for this particular video here is it's going to take a few seconds or maybe longer depending on how long the video is to analyze it. And then it'll give you this percentage meter up here. And as I scrub back and forth I can see it kind of still shakes but in a more smooth fashion. Like if I turn it off you can see it's jittery but here you can see it kind of just shakes smoothly. I can increase stabilization more. Now what's the drawback to that? Well, the drawback is that it's zooming in on the video more. So I'm cropping out some of the edges so it can deal with as things shake making sure that it never has blank spots in around the edges anywhere. So now that I've done that you can see for this video where it was relatively stable to begin with it almost looks like it's on a tripod now. It's very well stabilized. So that's all I need to do is turn that on and now as I use this video in this project or maybe I don't even want to do anything else for the project, I just want to go from here and just share and export as a file, I can then get stabilized video out of this shaky video here. And of course the results are going to vary depending upon what you start with. Something that's very shaky, you're not going to see much except maybe some smoother shakes. And something that's really close to it where the camera was being held very steadily, you'll be able to get some great results like this.